together in the prayer of invocation, which is found on your projection screen. On this special of days, we praise you, risen Jesus, whose very name is rescue and salvation. Live with us today in our midst, here in this place. Let your resurrection shine in our lives as we are reborn. Abide with us, not only during this hour, but now and always. That your name may be praised in our lives, in our words, in our songs, and in our silence. Puppies and cats and kitties group, And they put this sign up and they'll make it's going to be fun and exciting. And that's all the announcements we're going to do this morning because we're here to worship. And please stand with me as we together say our purpose statement, and it will be on the projection screen. Everything that you'll need in worship today will be on our projection screen for ease for you. And our purpose is to develop passionate followers of Christ through the celebration of worship, the excitement of God's Word, the blessing of God's healing, the rewards of service, the mind of God's creation, and the joy of fellowship. We're all welcome at God's table. We are welcoming, open, and affirming church to all people of all races, genders, ages, sexual orientations, professions, previous religious affiliations, and nationalities, or mental and physical conditions. Now it's a time to pass the peace. The peace of the Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Greet someone you don't know and welcome.
The reading for this glorious Easter morning comes from 1 Corinthians chapter 15, verses 19 through 26. If for this life only we have hope in Christ, we are of all people most to be pitied. But in fact, Christ has been raised from the dead, the first fruits of those who have died. For since death came through a human being, the resurrection of the dead has also come from a human being. For as all die in Adam, so all will be made alive in Christ. But each in his own order, Christ the first fruits, then at his coming, those who belong to Christ. Then comes the end, when he hands over the kingdom to God the Father, after he has destroyed every ruler and every authority of power. For he must reign until he hath put all his enemies under his feet. The last enemy to be destroyed is death. So, if you can believe in the resurrection, you too can have eternal life. The key is faith.
Struggle to believe. that they may hear and believe, and hearing come at last within the boundaries of joy which are expanding ever outwards until they encompass all humanity, all creation. Glorious God, may all our lives be fulfilled in your love, even as together we pray your prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever. prayerfully and full of praise, gladly, while grateful, we present to you this day these gifts for your work in your world. May your name be praised wherever these gifts are received. May the promise of new life come alive in the lattice work of giving and receiving that was begun by you in granting us first life, then new life. O God, author of the resurrection, to you we give. With you we share all your suffering people, close and far. Amen.
By that time, Mary had returned to the tomb and was standing outside crying.
And as she wept, she stooped and looked in, and saw two white-robed angels sitting at the head and foot of the place where the body of Jesus had been lying. "Why are you crying?" the angels asked her. "Because they've taken away my Lord," she replied, "and I don't know where they put him." She glanced over her shoulder and saw someone standing behind her. It was Jesus, but she didn't recognize him. "Why are you crying?" he asked her. "Whom are you looking for?" She thought he was the gardener. "Sir," she said, "if you have taken him away, tell me where you put him, and I will go and get him." "Mary," Jesus said. She turned toward him. "Master," she exclaimed. "Don't touch me," he cautioned, "for I haven't yet ascended to the Father. But go find my brothers and tell them that I ascend to my Father and your Father, my God and your God." Mary Magdalene found the disciples and told them, "I have seen the Lord." Then she gave them his message. May God bless this, the reading of his holy word.
To make his presence known. Let me illustrate, as is my custom.
Lay Hobson had recently lost one of the most important persons in her life, an aunt who was almost a mother to her. And so she'd done a lot of crying. And one morning, her six-year-old daughter Katie, witnessing her mother's grief, painted a picture, gave it, with some other little tokens of love to her mom. And she said to her, "Mom, I want you to feel better." That night, when Lay was tucking Katie into bed, she thanked her and told her that her love gift did make her feel better. And then she added, "But Katie, I want you to know that Mommy may cry a lot because I loved Ola so much. But Mommy," Katie said, "I'm afraid you'll turn into a tear." "Well," laughed Lay, "if I turned into a tear, would you wipe me up?" "No," Katie said, "I put you in my eye. I put you in my eye." What a wonderful answer, filled with identity, incarnation, and oneness. Jesus identifies himself with us. He is the one with us and incarnates himself through us to reveal his victory over death, putting something into motion that will never stop. Life always conquering death. And again, let me illustrate. David Gelettner, who lost one eye and part of one hand to the Unabomber, said after his ordeal, and I quote directly, "I am no sentimentalist, but the point is too important to pass over." And he says this: "If you insert into this weird slot machine of modern life one evil act, 1,000 acts of kindness will tumble out." He said that because of the many kindnesses that came to him after the tragedy from his family and his friends and the FBI and the hundreds of medical people he encountered, he felt all of those blessings. And even all over the country, people sent their best wishes, their feeling for him and what he had suffered. We can say it another way. God's kingdom will always come. The light has come into the world, and no darkness could ever overcome it. Jesus is the King of a kingdom, and he invites you to be part of it. This is what Easter means. This is the good news, the gospel, that death and evil have been defeated by God, who is determined not to let evil and death have the last word. The words "Christ is risen" are words that signal a great divine victory, which our choir sang so beautifully about. So in the resurrection, Jesus not only was raised from the dead, he returned to us, to you and me. The risen Christ returns to his grieving followers. Time and again, God is with us, not because we've been able to come to God, but rather because God comes to us. All of our faith, all our hope rests upon this assertion that the risen Christ appears to us. The risen Christ appeared to me when I was going through a difficult time. In the early 70s, when it was not politically correct to do so in a sermon, I spoke in favor of gay rights. Some members exercise their right to call for a vote. The minister goes, or the minister stays. I was troubled by the whole thing, and as I prayed and meditated, Jesus appeared to me in a vision. And what was he there to do? Ready to wash my feet. I got the point. He washed his disciples' feet. What he wanted me to know was that I was his disciple. And there was nothing more important for that. Which way the boat would go was not as important as that. And that brief moment in that wonderful vision that was given to me, that one moment made all the difference, and the days following up until the positive result were not filled with anxiety any longer. because the greatest thing that could ever happen to any of us is to become a follower of Jesus and know that when we need him, he will appear. The risen Christ will come to us when we have needs. So don't rule out the fact that as a disciple, Jesus could appear to you as well. Maybe in a vivid dream, in a vision, or maybe through a person. That's the way God does so many things. A very good friend of mine, who due to a heart condition did not have a long life expectancy, spoke to me, asking me if anything happened to him to encourage his wife to marry again and have happiness with another as she had had with him. And it was true, he died in his early 50s. And in one of our conversations, he shared with me that as he was driving along in his car, he felt Jesus join him alongside him. He said there wasn't any conversation, just soul-filling companionship. In other words, Jesus wanted to be where my friend Raphael was. What a wonderful affirmation. An affirmation for you this Easter day. Jesus wants to be where you are. So keep an eye out, an ear out. You'll be glad you did when God shows up. To reiterate, we're already in the kingdom of God. We already have eternal life. And God has made a permanent connection with us in Jesus. And that connection is written in our hearts. Connections are so meaningful to us. A woman gave an elegant dinner party. Like myself, she likes everything to match. And it did. Until she brought out a gravy boat. Not only did it not match, it was old and chipped. Well, you guessed it. There was a story behind it. When she was a child, their home was flooded. As they lived near a river, they were prepared for flood to their home. Homes were raised 7 feet above the expected high water line. But this flood kept coming. So they moved everything that they could to the second floor. But eventually the water covered it as well. And then the floor collapsed. And everything they had tried to save, their books and papers and her mother's fine china, was gone. It was the only time the little girl had ever seen her mother cry. She sat at the top of the stairs, devastated. But before the family was evacuated, the little girl was able to find and save a gravy boat. You know how? She went fishing. She took a fishing line down into the depths of the waters in the house and managed to snag the gravy boat, which had a little chip in it, and it was because the chip was there that the hook was able to catch it. So when they were safely evacuated, she presented it to her mom. And for every celebrative family dinner after that, the gravy boat was always carried out and placed on the table of connection to everything that had existed before. The family home was not only flooded, but before the tragedy was over, it burned to the ground. But the gravy boat remained as a symbol of the little girl's love and the parents' grateful heart of connection that was written on their hearts. So it is what was written on your heart by God through Christ that brought you here today. And so may the love and joy of this sacred Easter morn remain with you as we celebrate now and experience another connection, the communion connection. All are invited to the table of Jesus. The Lord be with you.
Also with you.
Lift up your hearts. Table, not because you must, but because you may. And come not because you're qualified by your own righteousness, come because Jesus has invited you. Promise it that God is faithful and just to forgive you of your sins and take away all your unrighteousness. So I invite those who come in this faith to receive this sacrament as we confess our shortcomings to a forgiving Lord.
Jesus took bread, and when he had given thanks, He broke it and he gave it to them, saying, "This is my body broken for you and for many for the remission of sins." In like manner, after supper, he took the cup, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them, saying, "This is my blood of the new covenant, poured out for you and for many for the remission of sins. Do this as often as you drink of it in remembrance of me." Will the communion stewards please come forward at this time? Please come forward for communion at this time, and for prayer and anointing, if you will. May we join together in the prayer of thanksgiving. We praise thee, O God, for this remembrance of thy love poured out for us. Teach us to love thy sacraments of all gifts, thy house above all dwellings, thy scriptures above all books, the communion of saints above all company, and grant that as one family we may give thanks and glory to thy glorious name. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Don't keep this news to yourself. Jesus is risen. Jesus is risen indeed. Tell the world. Jesus is risen. Go with courage, speak with conviction, share with joy. And may the peace of God and the freshness of the Holy Spirit continue to rest in your thoughts and rule into your dreams and conquer all your fears. Amen.